हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू वावाईएस, वेलकम टू द डिस्कशन ऑफ द डेली एमसीक्यू। आज है 29th of June 2021 और अब हम डिस्कस करने वाले हैं आज के पांच करंट अफेयर बेस्ड एमसीक्यूज। तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं। फर्स्ट लेट अस डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन दैट वाज आस्क्ड यस्टरडे। कल का क्वेश्चन था, ओमकारेश्वर टेम्पल इज लोकेटेड इन विच इंडियन स्टेट। सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज मध्य प्रदेश एंड सम ऑफ यू हैव गिवन द करेक्ट आंसर एज वेल। सो यस्टरडे इफ यू सी इट वॉज जस्ट गिव मी अ मिनट सो यस्टरडे इट वॉज अभिजीत एंड शुभम हु गेव द करेक्ट आंसर्स। कंग्रेचुलेशंस। नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस दिस क्वेश्चन। सो ओमकारेश्वर टेम्पल एक्चुअली प्रीवियसली यूपीएससी हैज आस्क्ड ए क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन दिस। सो जस्ट आई हैव पिक्ड अप दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन सो दैट इफ यू डोंट नो यू कैन लर्न फ्रॉम इट। दिस ओमकारेश्वर टेम्पल इज लोकेटेड इन मध्य प्रदेश एंड दिस इज वन ऑफ द 12 ज्योतिर्लिंग्स। ओके, इट इज डेडिकेटेड टू लॉर्ड शिवा, दिस ओमकारेश्वर टेम्पल। एंड दिस ओमकारेश्वर टेम्पल इज लोकेटेड नियर नर्मदा रिवर, near Narmada River. So this is the information that we need to remember from the examination point of view. Okay, now let's move forward. But before that, just a small information guys, daily we are providing 5 MCQs based on the current affairs of that day. Okay, and these MCQs which are based on the current affairs will definitely help in your prelims exam. So make the best use of this initiative. And in the Telegram channel, we are posting all the 5 questions along with their solutions in a PDF format. So just you can download this PDF and you can go through this by yourself. If you need any assistance, you can get back to us and you can comment in the comment box as well. I'll leave the link of the Telegram channel in the description. You can join it. Now let's see the first question. Consider the following statements with respect to India Smart City Award 2020. India Smart City Award 2020. These awards were presented by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. First one. The second statement. Karnataka secured first position in the state awards followed by UP and Tamil Nadu. So we have to choose the correct statement. So the first statement is right. These India Smart City Awards were given by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Okay, the first statement is right. But if you see the second statement, this is not right because the first position this year went to UP in the state category. And so that's why it's not Karnataka. So the second statement is wrong. So A1 only is the correct answer. If you see some more information about this India Smart City Award 2020, this was released by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. This is the first important information that we need to remember. And these awards were announced on the occasion of 6th anniversary of the Smart City Mission, Atal Mission for the Urban Rejuvenation and Urban Transformation, which is AMRUT, and Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban. So these three initiatives were launched 6 years ago, and these awards were announced after on the occasion of this 6th anniversary. And the parameters for this rankings which were considered are the social aspects, the governance of the city, the urban environment, the sanitation, economy, the infrastructure and everything. So all of these important things along with urban mobility, that means urban mobility means the urban transportation, all of these things are considered. And another important parameter which was considered last year was this, the during the pandemic, the additional parameters of sustainable business model of integrated command and control centers and the COVID-19 management center. All of these things are considered because the cities which has to fight against this COVID-19, they have to set up some special centers, okay, to provide support in the fight during COVID-19 pandemic. So this is also considered this year. And this year, if you see in the 2020 awards, Indore was awarded the first rank followed by Surat. Sorry, Indore and Surat both were awarded first rank. Yeah, just a small mistake corrected. Indore and Surat were awarded first rank in the cities category. And if you see the states category, UP secured first rank followed by Madhya Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. UP is one, second Madhya Pradesh and third Tamil Nadu. I know most of you might be thinking UP is not that developed, but still when we consider smart cities, UP is performing very good. Okay, and if you see Union Territories, it was Chandigarh which was ranked first. Okay, so there are some more information I've given here. You can just pause and go through this. This is for your extra info. This is for your extra understanding. Okay. Now let's move on to the second question. Consider the following statements with respect to triboelectric nano generator TENG. First one, TENG make use of chemical energy present in the atmosphere in different form to generate electricity. Second one, it is simple, cost effective, biocompatible, transparent nano generator. So we have to choose the correct answer. A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, and D neither 1 nor 2. So here if you see this question, TENG, okay, so TENG actually make use of mechanical energy like the vibrations. As you know, vibrations are part of the mechanical energy. So this TENG use mechanical energy. So the first statement is right, sorry, wrong. First statement is wrong. But second statement is right. It is simple, cost effective, biocompatible and transparent nano generator. So B2 only is the correct answer. Now if we see some more information about this TENG. So TENG actually stands for, as you might have seen here, the triboelectric nano generator. TENG means it makes use of mechanical energy in the form of vibrations which are present everywhere in the atmosphere to generate electricity. That is the main thing. So recently scientists have fabricated a simple, cost-effective, biocompatible, transparent nano generator, which is TENG. It can generate electricity from vibrations all around for use in optoelectronic self-powered devices and other biomedical applications. And this project was funded by the Department of Science and Technology, DST, under the Government of India. Right? So if you see this TENG, actually, if you see here, the technique is given, the technique involved, the simple doctor's blade technique along with polyethylene triphthalene, which are some layers. Okay, so PET layers are used and doctor blade technique is used. So the energy harvesting TENG works on the principle of creation of electrostatic charges via instantaneous physical contact of two dissimilar materials followed by generation of potential difference. That means when two dissimilar materials come into contact, okay, then an electrostatic charge is produced. This electrostatic charge which is produced is used to generate the electricity because a potential difference will be created. So all of these techniques are used. Okay, so and also it is very advantageous because if you see the vibrations, they are available everywhere in the atmosphere. So and also these vibrations you can find in each and every part of the atmosphere. So if this can be converted into a scale where we can generate electricity and we can use it to light our homes, then this is going to be a game changer. Okay, and other methods to make TENG. The method employed till date to design TENG use expensive fabrication like photolithography or reactive ion etching, okay, and additional process like electrode preparation, sewing and so on. These are the extra things. Okay, and it's a very good renewable source. The TENG is a good renewable source of electric generation. Remember this. Now let's move on to the third question. Consider the following statements with respect to Sanyasi Rebellion. So Sanyasi Rebellion was in news recently. So that's why we have asked this question. First statement, the immediate cause of rebellion was the restriction imposed on the pilgrims visiting holy places, right? Second one, it took place under the leadership of Bhagat Jawahar Mal Singh Sahib in Western Punjab. We have to choose the incorrect statement. So make a clear distinction. Here they have asked incorrect statement, not the correct statement. So if you see this question, the first statement is right. The immediate cause of rebellion was the restriction imposed on the pilgrims visiting holy places. The first statement is right. But second statement, if you see, you might know or might not know that Bhagat Jawaharlal Mal and Sian Sahib, they are not related to this Sanyasi Rebellion. You might know, might not know. Keep it aside. But there is another clue that is given. It happened in Western Punjab. This is the another clue that was given. So this makes this statement wrong because this did not happen in Western Punjab. Rather, this happened in Bengal Assam region. Okay. So the second statement is incorrect one. And here the correct answer will be B2 only is the correct answer. So Sanyasi Rebellion, why it was in news recently? Because Indian Prime Minister paid homage to Rishi Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay on his birth anniversary, on his Jayanti on 27th June. On his Jayanti on 27th June. Yeah, so his epic novel Anandamath, remember Anandamath is written by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay, which is based on the Sanyasi Rebellion. Okay, and this happened in 1770. So during that time, Bengal was even facing famine and Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay became a very influential figure. Sorry, yeah, I think I told Jayanti is not birthday, but yes, Jayanti is birthday only. Sorry, it was my mistake. Okay, so if you see the immediate cause of rebellion, which was the restriction imposed on pilgrim sites visiting, which are being visited by the sannyasis. The sannyasis are not allowed to visit these pilgrim places, and then the revolt started by the sannyasis. Okay, so here some more information is given. You can just go through it. Yes, and another small thing, Bhagat Jawahar Mal, also known as Sian Sahib. Okay, they are actually part of the Kuka revolt. Kuka revolt, which was founded in 1840 by Bhagat Jawahar Mal in the Western Punjab. And it is not a Sanyasi Rebellion. Okay, so that is the information, extra information. Right, now let's move on to the next question. Consider the following pairs. This is a matching question. So article 371 is given and the corresponding states are given. So we have to match the correct one. So the correct answer here is, for this question, if you see the correct answer, so it was option A, because Article 371A is related to Nagaland, 371F is related to Sikkim, but 371H is not related to Karnataka. Okay, 371H is not related to Karnataka, and this is related to 371H Arunachal Pradesh, Arunachal, right? Now let's see about Article 371 and why it was in use. So recently, the former former Deputy Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, he has asked the center to grant some exclusive rights to Jammu and Kashmir citizens by amending Article 371. So as you might have known, in 2019, the Article 371 was removed, and the special provisions which are provided to the state of Jammu and Kashmir were taken off. Okay, so that's why this becomes important. So this 371, Article 371, if you see, it provides special provision to various states, and these states include Maharashtra, Gujarat, Nagaland, Assam, Manipur, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Sikkim, Mizoram, Arunachal, Goa and Karnataka. Okay, and these are the respective articles. You can just go through it once, right? Theek hai. Now let's move on to the next question. Just pause and go through this, guys. This might come into handy in some time in the exam. So next question, if you see the last question of the day, what causes the wind to deflect towards the left in the southern hemisphere? A, temperature, B, magnetic field, C, rotation of the earth, and D, pressure. So this is the previous civil services question of 2010, right? So here the question is, what causes wind to deflect? So wind deflection, basically, if you see, the primary cause, as you might have known, it is Coriolis force. So if anyone would have mugged up this Coriolis force, then they will not be able to answer this question. But if anyone would have understood what is the concept of Coriolis force, you will be easily answering this question. So Coriolis force is nothing but the force which is caused due to the rotation of the earth. So the correct answer is C, rotation of the earth. And this Coriolis force actually moves the wind in the northern hemisphere. It will be in the anti-clockwise, north anti-clockwise, and southern clockwise. Southern clockwise means the winds will be moving towards left direction. In the north, it is right direction. Okay? So that's the concept about this. So here the correct answer is C, rotation of the earth. And some more information I've given here regarding this Coriolis force. You can just go through this. Okay? Right. So these are the five questions of the day. Now let's look at the question of the day. So the question of the day is, Pinaka, which was in news recently, is related to what? You have to tell about Pinaka. Okay? So tomorrow we will discuss this question before the discussion of five questions. We will discuss this question. Okay? So and guys, before leaving, I would just like to inform about our initiatives. We have summarized the Vision monthly magazine, Vision test series, and the Vision, even the prelims and test series, both mains test series, both of them we have summarized, and also Vision PT 365 we have summarized. We have done this to ensure your preparation becomes more easy, because already you are facing a lot of issues with regard to preparation and material. So it is very important for you to have a concise material to revise well before the exam. So that is the reason we have launched this initiative. So if you like our initiative, you can just go to the Telegram channel and get the details over there. Okay, so that's it, guys, for the day. I'll see you again tomorrow with five more questions. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Jai Hind.